All right, so the idea is to believe in a more brilliant world. And of course, this requires a childlike state of wonder. As Alan Harrington wrote in The Immortalist, we must all remain uncompromising child voyagers and retain a child's eye view of what might be. What happens with adults is that we become jaded, you know, the been there's and done that's of the adult mind. It's a form of laziness. It's a form of dispensing with the here and now and jumping to the conclusions. It's a sort of impatience with lived life that we need to transcend. We need to re-engage with the senses. We need to awaken the mind's attention from the lethargy of custom and the film of familiarity and redirecting it instead to the wonders of existence. You know, absolute unmixed attention is a form of prayer. Looking begins with love. Love begins with looking. This is the eye of the child. This is the mind of the child. We're all born artists. We're all born ecstasy seekers. And then it just kind of gets like pummeled out of us. It gets like stripped away by banality. What is banality and boredom if not defenses the educated mind employs against experience so that it's not continually exhaustingly astonished, as Michael Pollan wrote in The Botany of Desire. And it's true, it would be astonishing to be open to it all at any given time. Just read James Joyce. But we must nonetheless strive to re-enter these spaces because these are the only spaces that have ever led to visions that have transformed the world. That, my friends, is that.